Hey YouTube, this is Firewizard23 and I'd like to welcome you to my latest Let's Play project. James Bond Jr. for the SNES, based off the animated TV show of the same name. I have not played this game in years, and this is an interesting play for me because this is one of the first Super NES games I ever had. It sucked then. but let's get started here before we spoil anything. Once it offers me to enter a password, but we start at the Warfield Academy. Have you heard the news, James? An agent of scum has stolen a priceless statue from one of the students here at Warfield. From what I can understand, the statue can be used to open up a long-lost temple which contains golden artifacts. We can't let scum get away with this. They'll use the gold to fund their evil plans. You must stop scum at once. You'll need some special tools for your trip, James. Your minicopter is armed with missiles and bombs. In due course, I should have some other goodies for you. Such as these special shrapnel-tipped missiles. And a shield attachment. Oh, nice. Once in the temple, you may run into some nasties, so I came up with this snake charm electro-view. And these super jump shoes to help you reach your lofty goals. I think his trouble is the work of Dr. Derange. He'll use the gold to fund his evil science tests. Dr. Derange usually travels with his henchman, Skullcap. Watch out for him. He's not bright, but he is tough. Hope I can remember to pack my suntan lotion. So we're heading to Central America. Let's go. Now that I have the statue in my grasp, the treasure of the lost temple will be mine! All that gold will help me fund my research. Skullcap, you must keep James Bond Jr. from interfering. Yes, sir, Dr. Derange, sir. I'll do what I can to stop him. He's a fool to mess with you, Dr. Derange. Enough, you idiot! Go get him! I confess to not remembering if the current thing was actually any good. It makes it seem as if it is. Okay. Yeah, switch weapons here. We have a punch attack, jumping. We have a revolving. Cool, that's cool. Okay. Jump! There we go. Punch out bad guys. I remember this level ends actually pretty quickly because there's Dr. Derange! Come back! And then we go to a copter stage for some reason. Okay. So unforgiving, it's not even funny. Because the moment you touch anything, you die. The trees or anything, you just die instantly. You'll probably see it more than once here. The shield! Thanks, IQ. You see my lives in the upper right corner there. This is an incredibly long stage for absolutely no reason. Necessary to kill everything just looks cool. Why you
doesn't look like much. It really won't. How unforgiving the game can be. Literally, I'm scum. Seriously, if the games can just bring this kind of firepower, they gotta bring their A-game. They gotta bring their A-game. I'm not gonna take this guy down. That's not fair. See, I win. I win, right? No. You gotta do it again. Oh, I totally beat him. You saw it. Y'all saw it. Yes! 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 I won. James Bond Jr. is victorious. Make it to the temple, but you haven't got to Dr. Drake. You're in big trouble, Bond. He's got the ram's horn. Oh no! That's bad news. Now that I've put a lid on the skullcap, I think it's time to give Dr. Drain some therapy. This letter's passport is 0007. Ironic. But next time, let's play James Bond Jr., we'll continue on to stop Dr. Drain. This is Firewizard23. Take care and bye-bye for now, everybody.